Sorry.
I
Back.
Yeah.
When?
Yeah.
One passed me here, yeah. This one just came round. Three balls came past here.
Yeah, just two balls.
Just two balls.
Yeah, it's
good. I thought it was three, to be honest.
Yeah. Thank you. Hello, everybody, Mrs. and Mr. I'm with David at live on IPA pool, ipapool.com. I'm Julien Renoux. I come from France, and we're looking at a great match with Christophe Lambert and. I don't speak. Okay. I think a lot of French people are looking at the live now, and Le Billard en Image would like to congratulate you. Sorry for my awful English. So Le Billard en Image would like to congratulate you for the streaming. And in France, the IPA is looking by a lot of internet. It's nothing. And Lambert on the black. Yeah, there is a 3-1 for Jimmy Crockston. So I would like to say hello to all the internauts are supporting us. Yes, supporting us with Claude Champeau, Paul Codric, Christophe Lambert, and me. So I'm going to try to explain the match just near David. Lambert on the break. At the break, sorry. Lambert à la case, donc. Je vais faire un petit peu de français aussi pour nos amis français. Donc je peux vous dire que pour ceux qui nous écoutent en France, que Christophe augmente son niveau par rapport à quand il joue en France. Il est vraiment impressionnant. Bon, là ce matin, c'est pas apparemment pas le top, hein. Il y a quelques loupés, mais je l'ai vu jouer hier. Il est assez impressionnant. Lambert à la casse, une jaune empochée. A beautiful table. Une belle table. Was little work to break and dash. Donc avec un peu de travail, hein, pour casser et fermer. Alors ici il y a du bon monde, hein, je peux vous le dire. On a vu, bon, il ne jouait pas, hein, mais il y avait Gareth Pott, Craig Marsh, Ben Davis n'est pas venu. Hein, il devait jouer contre Christophe hier, mais il n'est pas venu. So I say Ben Davis doesn't come. He must play versus Christophe yesterday, but no. Christophe qui semble vouloir partir sur les jaunes. La jaune à côté de la rouge à droite passe. Je pense qu'il va partir en bon coulé. Ouais, il est bien. Nice shot. Vous aurez compris en français, hein. Beaucoup. Alors il y a certainement des joueurs en France que vous ne connaissez peut-être pas, que moi par exemple je ne connais pas. Comme justement Jimmy Crockston, qui fait partie, donc comme vous le voyez, il a un polo blanc. Et polo blanc ici, c'est les pros. Ce sont les pros. Alors Christophe, là, n'est pas soumis à la règle de la minute. C'est pour ça qu'il prend énormément son temps. Enfin, énormément son temps. Un peu plus qu'en France pour pouvoir... jouer. Donc n'étant pas soumis à la règle de la minute, bah, il prend tous les paramètres. Et je peux vous dire qu'il laisse rien au hasard. On décide de la jouer en bande. Ah oui, et Jimmy Croxton qui félicite Christophe. Jimmy Croxton, congratulate Christophe. Okay, I'm sorry, but I must go to play. David, thank you for what are you doing, and I hope I will come again today to. Okay, thank you very much. Allez, à tout à l'heure les petits Français. Ciao, merci.
Thank you. Thank you.
kicking out, but when I get down, it looks like I'm going to hit past without touching the block.
Once you say that, it will pay something there. Thank you. Chambers.
Oh yeah, yeah, did you notice?
It's very nice.
It's doing absolutely well. Both people are spending a fortune in that.
Test, 1, 2, test. Well, good early afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. You join us in what may be the final frame of this match. Although Jimmy more than capable of making some kind of comeback. Nice to see Christoph's very calculated approach on the IPA tour once again. So looking at it, the only slight problem ball is the one you can just see near the black, and if we just switch quickly. To the second camera, you can't quite see, but it doesn't look like it goes past the black into the right centre pocket. As he's looking at trying to develop now, you can just play this red into the bottom right pocket, come off the cushion into that red nearest the black. It's not going to be guaranteed to leave himself a shot though. Yeah, that was always the risk. You can see quite clearly now that it doesn't go past the black. I'm not really sure what option Christoph is going to take. More than likely he might be able to snick the one at the bottom of the table. Doesn't look it, so maybe he's just going to flick off the red, come back off the cushion at the right and up behind the red or the black and leave Jimmy snookered. See Paul Coldrick and Claude Champeau top of your screens. Travelled in from France. I think the idea there was for the white to be up behind the black, but it didn't happen. Jamesy always very, very keen to attack the table and go at it. But sometimes it makes sense just to hold back a bit, Jamesy. Especially at 8-4 down in a race to 9. But this is the key shot now. It looks like he's trying to go through a little bit here. Screwed it right back on. That little kiss off the knuckles made his job a little easier. I don't think that yellow goes past into the right centre. If he'd have missed that knuckle, he'd have come back far enough, but now he's in a bit of a fix. Played the plant with power and he's been unlucky. Yeah, there's no other way of looking at it. He was unlucky to get the kiss on the knuckle, and now he's unlucky not to leave himself anything. And I think he's a bit resigned to the fact that he doesn't fancy the job now. Still, that's turned out pretty well. Thank you.
try to go shop from Christoph. James now. Gonna try and figure out something miraculous again. As long as he gets the white ball off the top cushion back down behind this black, he'll be pretty happy. And that'll do him. Nothing particularly easy here for Christoph. If Christoph can get through to the cushion before the red at the top left, then you may find him laying a snooker off that one. We'll just switch to it. And you can see it's not going to be that easy, but all he's going to try and do is get to the ball at the bottom of the table near the pocket, and it will leave a snooker. Oh, what a slice that was. As Sid Waddell would say, thinner than a sparrow's eyelash. Jimmy in very bleak situation. It's not an easy positional shot really to get on the red at the top centre pocket, so Christoph might be playing for his free visit. Oh, and James got a right result there, but both players having a good laugh there. James is clearly quite fortunate. Made it a touch awkward now, Christoph. He's quite straight on this red to the top left pocket, which means he's going to have to play the final red on the top cushion into the right pocket. He just stopped this dead, might bring it back a couple of inches. So really it's just the pot he's got to worry about, because the white will naturally come down towards the black. It's gone down, and James doesn't make Christoph pot the black, and Christoph progresses into the next round of this event. We'll be back shortly with another game, which we'll go and find out what that is for you now.